But
there you go. Butt cheeks.
Dude, really? What the fuck? Lemonade. Yeah. Hey, what was that one say? Pull up in a side, homie, got a cup. Cut. Ice cream lemonade. What? Oh, pull
up in a table. Thanks, his brother, by the way.
Ice cream lemonade. I eat. Y'all need to get away. Fly free. Nigga, put your head away. I gotta see this.
Might have more
this one, but I'm gonna keep it cold. But I'm looking at my
fucking
mouth.
I'm gonna shake my
lips. So I just broke. He's been lacking a bit.
All right, everybody, what's up? I'm Martimus here with another episode of Smoking That Ish.
What up,
dude? On YouTube and now on Instagram. So suck it, other people who aren't. So there we go. We're here with Eugene from Dakota Natural Growers, the head cultivator.
Yeah.
The guy who grows the stuff you love. That guy.
You should like the way you smoke.
Yeah.
Yes.
Make sure you're smoking good shit too.
We did a couple of yours on here. What was it, the Frozen Fuel? You did the Do-Si-Do.
Yeah, we did a couple. I got them on my phone over there.
And then
yeah,
there was, I think we did another one too. Been pretty
quick. Gushers.
Gushers. Yep, that's what it was.
What was that like? Because that shit's old.
The Gushers, it had a nice taste to it.
It was low THC, but nice high.
Yeah.
It was one that I was surprised that I liked.
It was a nice airy. So that's something you can smoke up, wake up in the morning, smoke a big one, and it's not going to fuck you up a little bit too much.
Right.
For people who don't smoke a whole lot, you know, take their two hits and they're fucking zonked out.
Yeah, or, you know, somebody who feels like they have to always be smoking, but have responsible shit to do.
Yep.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, that's...
Not get too fucking...
That was a good one. I liked that one. That one was nice.
Yeah, Frozen Fuel. Frozen Fuel was a good one.
Yeah.
The Lemon OG Do-Si-Do.
Yeah.
And then the Gushers, yeah.
Okay.
The Gushers turned out really good. He was skeptical. He was skeptical.
Because of the low THC.
Low THC. Like, nah, man, this one's...
It usually takes a lot. I have a horrible anxiety disorder and shit. So, fucking, I have to smoke or I can't leave my house. If I don't smoke, I'll be, like, sitting on my bed crying. You know, just, I literally can't.
Yeah, so function. It has to affect it. You have to, it has to fucking affect you.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, I need the, what everybody else dreads, you know.
Therapeutic smoke, not social smoke.
Yeah. If you turn the mic just a hair towards you.
Therapeutic you smoke, not social smoke.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But I'm social with it.
Right.
It brings me down to everybody else's level.
Yeah,
I'm not freaking the fuck out all the time.
Generally, that's how it works, you know?
Yeah.
Unless you, like, I was talking with a lady at the flower shop. I did a meet the grower there. And, and we were talking about those things. And, like, that's the kind of strains that I like to grow for is the more, you know, the stuff that is... Not necessarily higher THC, but higher potency. When I say potency, I say that, you know, very lightly. I don't mean like just because it's 30% or 27%. That's not the potency issue. That's not how I view that, right? Like, potency is, man, did I smoke that shit and how high do I get if I smoke a whole joint of it by myself?
Yep.
So I like the stuff that's going to punch people. Like, punch you out, you know, it's going to be good for cancer patients with, you know, who need something heavier, more narcotic. If you have like sleep issues, it'll help with those. People who have like appetite disorders, like they can't eat, you know, that problems issues.
Is there any way you can work on like disconnecting your mic and maybe swapping those? Like, I don't know how
Yeah,
we had problems with it. We restarted the system and stuff, and it's still doing it. And I'm not a huge fan of it. I want it to be,
I know we had
much,
I know it
much
happened
crispier.
Once, I know it happened once before.
But we're used to technical issues on the show because
I know when it happened once before. Yeah. They said it turned out all right though.
Yeah, I know.
I mean,
yeah. Still, it's
I'm gonna mute mine. So
our first guess, it's got to be mute yours so you can figure it out. And then once you figure out how to do that one, it should be just click. You'll have to hold yours for a second one.
Yeah, that's
connect
all good.
That one. And we should be back in the game because I want everything that you're saying, you know, this is important stuff for the show and I want it to be crisp and clear. I don't want people to be distracted at all by like fading in and out or anything like that.
We good to keep rolling or no?
Oh yeah, you can keep going.
Yeah, for sure. So
he's working on it and none of us have any idea what we're doing. So it's a random amount of time it's going to take him.
Yeah, it's all good. But like, I like growing for stuff that's going to help people that have that need that heavier narcotic smoke, that because that's what I like to smoke, I guess, obviously. But
that's so what I look for too. Yeah.
Yeah. I want it to be danker. You know, if you need like help, you know, help feed an appetite, you know what I mean? If you have an eating disorder or you don't have, people just not hungry, you know what I mean? Maybe you have you just have issues with fucking getting food down, but so smoke some bud.
Mm-hmm.
That's nice. Get stoned as hell. Enjoy eating some food, grilling some food. That's my kind of thing. The super potent buds, man. I don't like growing the you just, you know, when you smoke something, you're just like, man, well, fuck. Load another one?
Yeah.
And that's, I mean, once you get to that point and you're spending a bunch of money on stuff, like, I don't give all this terpenes matter shit, like, Terps matter. Obviously, you want to smell you want your weed to smell good.
What's the you want said to before smell that there was like a soapy terp? What's the terp that tastes soapy?
It tastes like fucking soap. I don't know what it tastes like. It tastes like soap. You know what I mean? Yeah. I don't
want to know.
I think that a lot of this testing shit, THC testing, terpene testing, all that stuff.
I think it's hit or miss, honestly.
It doesn't dictate what good weed is.
No,
like, you can't focus on the percentage.
Yes.
And find what good weed is, because even I've gone high percentage and you find some that just, it's not a good weed. I mean, it'll get you stoned, but it's not fun to smoke.
Right.
You
know? It's not enjoyable to smoke, and terpenes don't translate to flavor, right?
Yeah, just go ahead. What I need you to do is just unplug that one. Plug that one in, and he'll hold it in his hand while you disconnect this one.
We're going to black him out. Oh, he's going to switch. Oh, I see you.
Yeah, because he can't show his face. So we're going to go black screen here.
We're going to make people fall. We're going to make...
No one gets to know what BK looks like, and we're going to keep it that way. So if you're seeing a black screen right now, it's because you're supposed to. Everything's working just fine. It actually automatically happens when BK gets on the screen. We don't really know why, but every time BK just gets on the screen, it just blacks itself out. Won't even show him. We've tried. Can't even get pictures with him.
Must be a bug.
Yeah.
Or he's something dead. Weird. Is he actually dead?
I don't know. Maybe. BK? I've never checked his pulse. I'm not touching. We're friends. I'm not like.
I never really seen him sleep either. Seen him sleep either. This man might be a vampire behind the screen.
Might be. Maybe that's he just leaves and says.
What's your blood type? Sleep. BK, what's your blood type?
Any. He's like about a quart. I have no idea what my blood type is either, dude.
Nah, it all bleeds the same.
And I'd be like, what's your blood type? I'm gonna be like, fucking you figure it out.
All right, there we go. We good?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh, dude.
That work.
Bravo, BK. Look at that.
We got to continue. Let's see. There it goes again.
Oh, it's the fucking cord, dude. It's the cord. You fucking. We figured it out. You broke the cord.
I didn't break.
You did. You did. Because it's your fault. You sat over there before. One of the early episodes, he sat over there. Everybody saw him drop the mic off the thing. Fuck. And he dropped it off of there twice. And he didn't ruin the mic, but he broke the damn cord.
No, because I didn't drop it.
Because that's what he does, dude. He just wrecks stuff.
So is it just fucked up on the audio end of this and it comes through clean on the other end or what?
I've heard, because when we did that episode,
it dips out. It still dips in and out, but it's not as dramatic as you hear in your headset.
Because I was told this, because when we first started, I was having some audio issues. But
he kept blurring me out because he was so animated when he would talk. This would autofocus on his hands, and then I'd be blurred for the rest of the episode. But yeah, we are. Like, this might be the 10th episode, maybe. We are fresh. Fresh.
Yeah.
Yeah, we didn't build this. This is something my brother had, and we were out at the bar, and I was like, why don't you let me do a podcast? And he was like, sure. And I was like, are you serious? And he goes, yeah. And like 2 days later, I was like, dude, we're doing a podcast.
The model of it's almost flawless. I mean, really, right? Like, you just fucking review the chronic, talk about chronic.
Yeah. Well, if we were sitting at home and just chit-chatting and stuff, we would just be talking about weed anyways.
And that's smoking one thing. It. And that's
we were
one
hanging
thing.
Out. If we were at each other's houses.
And that's another thing about it is there's a lot of people, like, even though, what have we got, like 10,000 Medicare patient now? Something like that, around there.
10,000.
Yeah, but I know at first it was like maybe 2 to 4. And that was one thing, is there's a lot of misinformation. Yeah. And a lot of just, I don't know.
Yeah.
So then there's also that side of it too, because that was honestly the main thing. That was the question that I get asked the most when I got my little at home setup going and everything like that in my car. And everyone, it was the most asked question is, well, how? And it was just a bunch of hows. Or how'd you do this and how'd you do that? So a lot of it was also misinformation.
Right.
And that's something also, like, I know people that still don't have theirs, but they've been out looking for podcasts. Actually, they found the coffee house is what it was.
Right.
They ended up finding that. So they've been looking. So I know that there's people out there still looking just to have a little bit more knowledge on it.
Yeah. And
yeah, just to find out, you know, more info.
Yeah.
And real reviews, ranking, you know, calling out the bullshit too. That's not
that sucked so hard because I was such a big fan and I pushed that so hard. And then just to see a shitty bag like that, just.
And it was honestly.
Tore me apart. He's bounced back, by the way. Not shitting on him again. He bounced back. No, he saved two strains. Saved two strains that are fantastic. If you liked it before, go check it out.
Yeah. And that's constructive criticism, right? I mean,
some
people get upset about it, but you know, I think a lot of our shit, I get yelled at by the people in our building all the time because I say we still suck, everything sucks. I tell them so. Like, I know that we can be better, and like every cultivator should feel that way, right? Like, if you feel like you're so good at growing pot, and you grow some bullshit and someone says it sucks and you're like, man, fuck you, that weed's good. Like,
but you know, it's not though.
Right.
But you know, it's not.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, people get defensive but over their
ego
strains.
There's an ego in it, right?
Oh yeah. Like, they let their ego get in the way. That's everything though in life.
It is.
Everybody lets their ego get in the way.
And it's really bad in weed.
And they take everything personally.
Cause like weed is art, right? Like, and if you fucking brought your art to the show and motherfucking no one bought that shit, like,
you'd be like,
God damn, man. Like, fuck you guys. Like, I don't know what they were thinking.
That's one thing though. I feel you on the everything sucks part. Cause even mine, I was looking at it while I was growing and this and that. And even up until now, I'm still just like, no.
It can be
Oh, that's but fuck, man. Nope. There's just more. Every time it's just a little bit. I've noticed, even throughout just this first one, I've noticed like every other day you're like, okay, well, this is different today. Or I underwatered a little bit, maybe.
Right.
Or I might have did a little bit something here. Or I fucked up my climate or something. It's just little things like that. And then you're like, okay, I can't do that anymore.
Right.
And then even here with this one, mine turned out pretty decent, but my trimming fucking sucks. For now, it sucks. And then I still got the fine tuning here or there. And so it's little things like that. So I see where you're
coming from. I thought it looked good. I told you how I trimmed. I thought it looked good.
It wasn't bad. I know I have.
You want to tighten?
I've never complained about it.
That's what it is. I got to tighten it a little bit. I still get some harshness on it. Just a couple leafy ones in there. I get some harshness.
Right.
So that's my issue that I've noticed from the end of it. And then just.
Yeah, on his buds that he grew.
And then the rough.
Did you dry it and jar it right away?
I dried it. And then I think it was like a couple weeks. I did about maybe 30 days, a little bit less than 30 days. And then I jarred it.
Right.
But it did sit for a couple of days with the whole trimming thing because it was just me. I actually had BK come over and help me pluck some big boys off.
Right.
But, and then it was about 2 or 3 days of trimming, just trying to get it all worked out. And then I think I jarred them for about 30, 40 days.
So get like a, go and get what, you know, the black toast with the yellow lids?
Yep.
Snatch one of those up. And when you're done, like, don't take any leaves off. When you hang that shit and when you take it down after you dry it, put it in that fucking
There you go, turn it right towards you.
Yeah, put it in that
That fucking mic, dude.
That fucking mic, man.
Hey, BK.
But put BK, it in that, you know,
we,
what I mean?
So
put
take
it,
a break.
Put it in that tote. See, and fucking leave it in that tote on the sticks.
Yeah,
I think it hardens that bud up a little bit better. And it slows that chlorophyll. It really just slows the fucking dry down, so because chlorophyll leaves the back of your weed off moisture, right? So like extra time inside that tote, like, is better to me than cutting off all those leaves. I would let those leaves stay on. If you did have to jar it and you didn't tote it, I would just throw it in the jars with all the leaves on and to just wait. And really, you know, it's dialing in your drying cure, just fucking getting better every
fine-tuning
run. That's all it is. Yeah, you just get better every run.
Fine tuning.
Because like, you'll always fuck something up. You know what I mean? You're always gonna fuck something up. Like, so many times, I mean, it just never. A lot of the grows never go exactly as you plan. You know, plants get bigger than you thought they would. They're more finicky than you thought they would be.
Yeah, I noticed I had more issues with the car crasher.
Yeah.
The Johnny Utah went pretty solid, but the car crasher was getting a little...
So you can be like a perfectionist, but it's never going to be perfect.
Right. That's what a perfectionist is, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it's not good. It's right. Like, yeah. It's gotta be better. It's not good enough. It's not good enough. It's not good enough. It's not good enough. While the normal person looks at him and they're like,
well, it's pretty goddamn good. Pretty fantastic. Right. I mean, I don't see what the problem is,
but you know, ultimately as a grower, that's what it like. I've honestly seen more people quit than get good realistically. And like when you look at, when you look at the face of where weed is now in South Dakota, right? Like go back to this point in time a year ago, right? And everybody's different. The faces of the industry are significantly different. You know, some people have fallen off. Some people have fucking fallen back. Others have come up. And
yeah, we've seen a couple missteps.
Yeah.
By a couple different companies.
Yeah, you see some discrepancies, but just in,
as long as it's a learning experience, I don't see what the issue is. Like I said, I don't freak out if I find seeds in something. If I find seeds in something like multiple times,
you know,
if I find it in like three things in a row, I'll probably leave that thing alone until they have like a special release or something.
Some,
you know,
and some dispos are, you know, that's where if they know that pack seeded too, they should be letting people know, and it shouldn't be full price. You know,
yeah.
If you know you got a seeded fucking bag of weed, like I mean, one or two here and there. If you find a seed here
Dakota
and there,
Green, that's you had a couple floaters.
Dakota
here
Green did that.
It's expected, really.
Dakota Green had light leak issues, and they put out a thing, and they said they had light leak issues, and but they thought it was still really fire bud, so yeah. They still wanted to sell it. They said there is some seeds in there, you know, pre-warning you, so yeah. You don't just roll them up and smoke them.
Yeah.
And then they put 4.2 grams in there and sold it for their 3.5 price.
Shout out to those guys, Dakota Green, the Terp Ranch, my homie Mango.
Mango is a maniac. In Nevada, dude.
Those guys kick ass, and they were the first ones who came to market and said, fuck this high price bullshit, right? Like everybody in the planet or everybody in the state thought their fucking weed was worth $5,000 a pound, right? And then they come over here and they started dropping them for $3,200 a pound, dude, and people are like, oh fucking what? There were some people like didn't understand that, but like, you know, I thought Mango's slogan, what the fuck was it? Make smoking doobies cheap again or something. Shit like
hell
that.
Yeah, dude.
It was rough
over here, just in the South Dakota area. People don't tend to make as much. Well, see, and
that's where brand loyalty is going to come into play extremely right now, because the consumer in South Dakota learned like the hard way, right? Like they couldn't have learned any more difficult. Like the entry into this fucking industry as a medical consumer was so terrible out of the gate, and. It just dispensaries were buying terrible, terrible pot and then just like still selling it for like you were buying knowingly seeded weed for $55 to $60 an eighth. And you know, now we gotten to the point where some of that shit's still on the shelf, dude.
Yeah.
And you know, now it's a whole different list of cultivators at the top. You know, you got us, you got the Terp Ranch now, at Dakota Green, From the Hills is starting to make a little noise.
Yep, they're doing decent with a couple of theirs.
Cannonaut was making a little noise there for a little while, and
Cannonaut's hit or miss.
Yeah, is he?
Yep, we had one on that we didn't think was great, and we had one on that we thought was pretty good.
Rare Earth doesn't do bad.
Rare Earth is they stand by their name though. They're hard to find.
Yeah.
They don't mess with a lot of people.
I've known Greg for a while, and he's really, he's the smartest dude that I know when it comes to soil. I talk to him and I feel stupid. But he's really particular in what he puts out there. I know that he didn't even release like the first, I believe he didn't even release a batch, and then they wanted to sell it as buds, and he fucking pre-rolled it all because of seeds and was very open to fucking just put it on a progress pre-roll. Don't make any excuses about it. So he's all about quality. And I know I've heard a lot of good things about his power nap.
That was nice. Yeah, we did grab that one. That was nice. But what's funny about that is it did not knock you out.
No.
Because I walked in.
Well, that's for me. It was perfect for me, dude.
I walked in. I didn't even look at nothing else. I'm walking around and I see Power Nap and I'm like, give me that.
Yeah.
Like, now I was like, I want that. I don't even. Yeah. I'm not looking nothing else.
That's
like,
it. We don't look at what company is selling what. That's part of what we like about like Tea Tree,
right?
Is they don't have it in different. They have it all in their jars where they have the little light on it and the magnifying glass, yeah. So you can see the butt.
Yep.
That's the jars you look at. Yep. So you're not paying attention to whose is what,
right?
And you just pick strictly based off of what you think is the best,
right?
And that's where we ended up with your
one. Yeah, and they're thank you.
Yeah, no,
but
thank
the homie,
you.
Homie Rare Earth, those guys are really good, but they're so small batch. Like, you know, they're real small batch.
Everybody says, yeah, that's
yeah. They don't really they don't ha- get yeah. They don't have a lot of they don't have the scale that you know he doesn't have the space that some of us have to grow in,
mm-hmm.
And that's you know that's kind of and I think you know. With that space, if they did have that space, you know, he would need a lot more help over there. But if he had space and had help, man, holy cows, those guys could be.
He does good. Every time we pick something up, I don't think it's been anything below pretty damn good.
Yep.
He's done good with that.
So yeah, he dropped
Rare Earth.
It's
never been a miss.
They just dropped some, they just did like a little hash collab with like that Scotty Tuhati. Water hash too.
Okay.
Oh shit.
Yeah, with From the Hills. I think it was From the Hills. Maybe it was High Hills, man. I hope I got that right. Sorry to either one of you guys whoever is.
Sorry to whoever is not involved.
Yes, yes.
But to whoever is, big props.
Right.
But you guys figured it out.
He does real good. He does real good. He's you know, he's only gonna get I think that their business model is actually fine though. You know what I mean? If you don't have a lot of investors and a lot of money that, you know, a lot of people coming calling for paychecks and shit like that, that need dividends or whatever the hell these investors are getting back, right? If you're small, like South Dakota's 10,000 patients right now. And even if it goes wreck, right?
Yeah.
Let's say it goes wreck. Where's the Minnesota just went wreck. So Worthington's business is gone. There's going to be 5 dispensaries in Worthington for sure. One in Laverne probably too. Like if they've had the head shop there forever.
Everywhere they'll let them have it.
Right.
Everywhere they'll let them have it.
So you're not getting any business from Minnesota, right? North Dakota, man, who the fuck's going to go? Where are they going to buy it in Northeast or Northern South Dakota, right? Like that whole border's fucking nothing. There's nothing up there. Wyoming may like it's like maybe a little pulse over at the hills. But nothing major, like nothing that's going to turn fucking the 6,000 people over there smoking into 20,000.
Yeah.
And then you've been to the Sand Hills, man, in Nebraska. Mm-mm. Well, fucking nothing out there, you know? So
I've driven through a lot of Nebraska.
Yeah, there's nothing there.
Like, well, same thing with Eastern South Dakota. It's just nothing.
So I don't understand these big aspirations that people have for this massive rec market. Like Sioux City is going to give you a good pulse of business. For sure.
Yeah, you get some there. Pier will be decent.
Yep.
Obviously, the big ones, but...
Right. But outside of that, man, like, it's not going to be this big million-dollar market in South Dakota. So, like,
For some people, it will be.
Well, no one's going to make 40 mil in 10 years, you know?
No.
No one.
No.
No one. No, you know, there's no... It's never... You can make a good living, but you're not going to fucking just...
Well, it's a nice way, like, when places first go medical, it's a nice way to get started and get your foot in the door,
right?
You know, for somebody who wants to start up. Because in the states where it's already like a big thing, the guys with the big money, as soon as they hear you're starting something up, they'll shut you right down.
Right.
I mean, they'll come and just
see, and
they'll block you off and just shut you
down.
And
that's where I think that model won't work out here, right? Because the consumer base is so small. It's not Minneapolis. It's not Omaha. It's not even Omaha. It's not even Des Moines, you know, it's so small that any type of corporation that'll come in and try and fucking just throw out fucking 100 pounds every fucking 2 weeks, dude, like if it sucks even if it's good, you can't sell it all. Like where are you going to bring it? You're not going to sell it all. And then if it sucks No one's gonna buy that shit. Again, like, we're in Minneapolis, dude. When Minneapolis rec goes in Minneapolis, it's gonna be fucking.
It's gonna. They go in effect August.
And there's gonna be so many dispensaries in Minneapolis, dude.
Actually, they were talking about. So there are gonna be a lot. That'd be a good. But they were talking about.
That'd be a good scene to have a hand in right there.
They might not have dispensaries open for like a year. Is what I was talking. So I'm from Minnesota. My sister's there. And I was asking her about it, and she was saying that it goes in effect in August, but right now the laws are kind of weird. But it went in effect, but not fully. So like, you can have your weed, and you just cannot buy your weed. That's what you can have it,
but you can have your weed and smoke it too.
You can have your weed and smoke it.
Plants, I think too.
Thank you. It's eight,
six, if one per, eight for me. Six, eight per right, eight flower, eight veg.
Four. It's 4-4.
That's all right.
Yep, it's 4-4, and then I think it's up to like.
Put four of them in a 10x10. One per light.
But I think they got 2 pounds for their house limit, 2 ounces obviously on person limit. And then
that's fucked.
Their concentrate limit bit, though, I think their concentrate limit's only like
maybe. So it's not legal, that's regulated.
Yeah.
It's not a legal pot.
That's no.
That's not as regulated. Then,
oh, everywhere where they say it's legal, it's regulated. Regulated. They don't trust us with it.
And our concentrate.
Which is like, that's a big thing. Like, I'm almost 40 like tomatoes, fucking years man, old. You know? And I got a guy that's a little bit older than me who doesn't smoke weed telling me that I can't have X amount of weed because it's going to be bad for me.
Right.
It's like, fuck is wrong with you?
What's our limit right now? What is it?
It's 3 ounces every 2 weeks.
Which is pretty decent, really. Yeah,
because right now you can get 3 ounces of concentrates or you can get 3 ounces of
flower.
And that's
the big thing is our concentrates compared to Minnesota, our concentrates are up there. So like we can get up to 3 ounces of concentrate. I think they can only get like 6 or 7 grams at a time, something like that.
I mean, 3 ounces of concentrate in 2 weeks is fucking.
Bro, you've seen how some of these guys were smoking them out west, man. Holy shit. But dude, we smoked some of them from the hills. Some of those were decently terpy, man. I was digging on some of those last weekend.
I had a good one. I had the AK-47 crumble, which was 88%. And that was, I was taking this other jam. And I would get the jam, and then I would roll it in the crumble, and then I'd do that for a dab. That was fantastic.
Sure.
But right now I have Bruce Banner dabs, this live rosin butter from the hills, which is it's pretty good. It's not bad.
Nice.
I don't think I've bought a concentrate.
But like I said, in Mitchell, we can't. Your stuff's not there, so. That's the only reason, and we're lazy.
Superior buds. Come on, man.
Superior buds.
Been to the building, man. Dude, you've been to the building.
Dude, shout out, too. And you had, you were supposed to be here, man.
Yeah, and I love.
Opportunity.
I like Superior Bob. Superior Bob's good shit.
I like the small companies, you know what I mean? I like.
They
like,
took over.
They are.
I love Teachy,
but they're so small that they're still kind of nervous.
they took over the old GameStop building.
Oh, they got to get some weed that'll sell in a week.
Yeah, they do.
If they would buy, it would. I'm Superior Butts. I'm telling you, it's you buy a quarter pound or a half pound on Saturday or Friday. You put it on the shelves Friday, man. You're gonna call us by fucking Monday. It's gonna be gone. It's nice. Gonna go like that. Honestly, we get called all the time, especially on the east side because we're not really very well represented on the east side. Like honestly, a lot of our pot goes out west, and I really want to improve that. And we have a drop coming up on 7/10. That's the target date. Some stuff might hit. I'm hoping there might be a couple strains that that smoke real well. And don't require that full 6 week cure to get some stuff on the market. And some
that'll be like some 4th of July shit though.
I'm hoping so.
Yeah.
I'd love to have a couple things on the shelf on the 4th.
Yeah.
And we really want to hit like
holiday weeds. Like,
it's great, man. Like
I'm such a fucking child
for sure, man. And, but you know, that's what people are doing right on the 4th of July. What are people? And I wanted 4th of July more than 7/10. I know 7/10 is sentimental to smokers. Obviously, flowers, not hash, right? But it's still the best.
But it's still a part of it.
It's the best we could do.
Yeah.
So it's cool. But the 4th of July, man, is relatable to everybody, right? Like every single person, unless you're fucking lame, it's going to be barbecuing, drinking, smoking, hanging out with friends, fucking having a good time, throwing bags, throwing horseshoes, doing whatever the fuck you do on the weekends, man. But you're going to be having a good time with your friends. And that's big to me. That's why it was huge for Memorial Day weekend. You know, we had our drop come out Memorial Day weekend, and across the state, we had almost everything out, in time for everyone to enjoy it on the holiday weekend. And until, you know, so that's that matters to me. So hopefully we can get it a little bit for the fourth, but definitely 7-10. And shit, Superior could hit us up. And
hell yeah,
they do got a they do have a nice little story.
Superior Bob's phone number. Ooh, the things I could do with your phone number, Bob.
I could. You got my phone number.
Oh shit!
So look at
what if I connected those two dots?
But it goes quickly, and we want to be over here on the East River Farms. We're gonna be at the flower shop, Tea Tree. We've been to Superior, and we love working with people who we have relationships with. That's who, you know. That's who we go to first. You know, if we have an existing relationship with someone, that's who we call first. And we usually don't get to the fifth or sixth caller, you know. It goes fast, but I like Mitchell. You know, Fruits Freya is over there. Shout out to those guys, and
yeah, Fruits Freya. Shout out.
And, you know, so we'd like to be over there. We'd like to sell them some more bud.
We would love it if you were over there.
Yeah, honestly, I would be
thrilled.
and they're small enough that, you know, they could always get, you know, whatever's fresh. We're close, man. Like it ain't that far.
Yeah, and they're big on new stuff, and they're bringing in new stuff all the time.
Who are they rocking with right now? Who's their
right now? I'm digging their From the Hills. They also have Badlands. Is it? It's Bad River.
Bad River. How are those buds?
Bad River, I was getting it for a while, but I was getting their 10 Gs, which was 25%, and it tasted really good.
Yeah.
And I was enjoying it, but then I found a couple of seeds in one of the bags, so I switched over. That was right when
Blackberry.
Yeah.
They're in living soil out there.
Yeah.
Okay.
In beds.
So that I switched to the Blackberry Kush.
Beds are nice. I want to give me some fucking beds.
So I've been smoking the Blackberry Kush from the Hills.
But they got a lot of From the Hills. And then they do have Bad River. They got the Pipple Acres guy. And then I want to say
DNS. Of course, yeah,
they do have some DNS out there.
New DNS or old DNS?
They got Ghost Magic.
New batch, or is that, because I know he's been rocking
it's
that.
It's almost. For, it's pretty high percent. I mean,
calling that GMO for a while.
But they do all decent. They took over the old GameStop building.
Yep.
So their storefront is a nice.
DNS cozy little storefront. A little high though.
Yeah, they do have a little bit high price. Unity has some high fucking prices.
Right.
Unity has some high prices.
Off the fucking half, dude.
Tea
Tree was a pleasant.
I guess
price.
I.
They got a nice Superior place. Buds, don't get me wrong. They got a man, nice
Buds
place.
Does their best to keep the price. Yeah,
we've only been there. We've only been to Tea Tree or into Unity one time. There's not much. We probably won't end up over there.
As I said, the vibe's off. The vibe is off for our area. It's so professional. It's
a cell phone store.
Yes. Yes. It's the Apple store for weed, dude. It is. Everybody's very professional. They all have a worked out like thing. They're all very, it's. Yes. Right. Can we get,
right.
I know that they do have people to try the products, but it's
I have
just,
never
they have
been
way
in,
too professional.
I have never been in the dispensary, and I've never talked to any of them. To either of those. I take that back. I guess I did a fucking face call or something with those guys or something.
Okay.
But I remember that event, that little event that they put on the east side. That was all right. Like their grand opening. Did you guys go to that?
I was there for that. I was there for the opening day. They did
the
nice.
Best part
there.
About it was the food they had there.
The taco truck?
Yeah.
Nope, I went there for that. They were nice when he was sitting there because he had a bunch of people sitting there for a while. They came out getting everybody chairs and waters and everything. So that was really cool. And that's actually when I found out that if you are 18, you cannot buy smokables. It was that day because there was some kid who was in line with me. He got his med card. And that's when they only had their ace in their joints. And he goes in. So he's sitting there for about 2 hours. And then he goes in. He's like, hey, here's my card. And they're like, oh, we can't sell you nothing. He's like, haha, what do you mean? It's because if you're 18, you have to buy like tinctures and edibles. Really? In the Dick Schmamption oil? Yeah, you can't buy it.
Fuck, man. Edibles are more fucking dangerous than a goddamn fucking joint is.
You can't buy inhalants.
Oh, that's
you
what
can't
they're living
it.
On.
You
that's
can't OD on a right fucking... Now. You can't OD on a joint, dude. But you fucking eat too much fucking edibles, boy, and it'll be a fucking... You'd be fucking ruin your night.
Yeah, you could have a bad couple days.
You can't buy vapes either because they're considered inhalant as well. So it can't be flower, can't be concentrate, can't be vapes.
Oh, and then for the edibles, you can't get more than 100 milligrams in a package.
That's the standard kind of thing sometimes.
Yeah, that also sucks balls because if I want to stop smoking, I have lung disease, I'm not supposed to smoke so much, but I can't fucking buy 10 bags of edibles every day.
Doesn't Colorado have higher limits for the med side, though?
For the med side, yes. For the med side, you get some 1,000 milligram.
Yeah, that makes a difference. Like,
yeah,
we did some R&D fucking edibles. They were passed out as R&D to us, and like, give us feedback on what you think of them, man. And they're like, "Fuck it, you wouldn't split these five with somebody." It was fuck, man. I won't even feel fuck 2.5, man. What the fuck? I might as well not even eat them.
Yeah,
you know, because
DNS did good with theirs. They have those little cubes, the rosin cubes. Those aren't terrible,
right?
Just, you know, throughout the day, when you gotta go get some shit done, just eat one of those, kind of coast you out a little bit, eat two of those. It's not too bad. But if you're like an everyday, I'm gonna eat me an edible thing, that's where you want them higher bits in there, just because you want something to smack.
I want to eat edibles like, fuck, man, once in a while. So like when I eat them, I like to eat like probably like 100 mil at least.
Yep. And then when you're buying a whole bag and it's 100 mil in the bag, you're like, well, fuck, I got
eat
the whole thing.
Yeah, then you eat all that fucking sugar, dude.
Yeah, it's a lot. God. It's a lot, dude. It usually makes me sick.
But I know Colorado, they got their drinks and everything now, and then they got the higher THC for the med side. I know I've heard of 1,000 bar.
Man, higher THC for the med side. Come on, South Dakota. Come on, buddy.
Well, they
come
can't.
On, man. It's medicine, dude. Do you think Rex can pass?
This next time, probably not.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
Not the next time. I don't think so.
What was that?
Maybe one after that, but I don't think it's going to pass next time.
Yeah, I don't even think they should run that, I'm honestly. Sad.
But so far on the med side, it's doing good, though. As far as what they've been doing, it's been doing pretty decent.
I think that Rec failing was the best thing that could happen to the medical program.
100%.
Without question.
Yep.
If Rec would have passed... Then
they would have just mass produced poo poo.
Oh, it would have been terrible.
The whole time.
It would have been terrible. And now some people are going to have to really.
Yeah, now you guys are setting a
standard. Oh, yeah, you got to be on your game. Everyone you got to be on your game, right?
It's really competitive.
Yep, like I said, you guys are setting a standard right now. So when Rec does pass and people come in and they're like, yo, check this out, it's going to be like, why would I want to buy that when I could buy this? From the same place, probably.
Yep.
And
generally, medical is always going to be cheaper than Rec. So, you know,
yeah,
that'll incentivize people to keep the med program going. But then,
I'm med for life. Shout out heart attacks. What's up?
Right. Right. Heart attacks, I'm a motherfucker, man. I got to watch out for those things.
Yeah. I had one in December.
Damn.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I caught him drinking a monster one day, hitting some frisbee golf. Yeah. I look over and I'm like, what the hell is this? What do you got there? Huh? What the fuck is in your hand, dude? Oh, so is that a monster? He goes, yeah. I'm like, you can't do that, my guy. I'm like,
oh, yeah. That's right. I just have a heart attack.
I just got my eyes checked. I just got my eyes checked, and I found out my blood pressure. I knew my blood pressure was high because I used to fight MMA, and it was always high back then. But they'd always blame it. Oh,
did you hear that? Other cultivators? Huh? Did you hear that? What? What? Say something.
We'll let the jar cracks tap it. We'll let the jar cracks fight it out, man. Like, I'm all about that. That's what I love about the West Side, you know, was the jar cracks, you know. So like, that's what I want with the Rec, you know. We can get fucking with Rec. That's what will be nice is you can have more openness with your events.
Yeah, that's a real big thing.
You can share your art
a little bit more socially acceptable to an extent. Because there's even especially on the east here, even. Like I said, there's a lot of prudy people. Not even prudy might be the way to put it, but there's just...
Well, some people would be, even if they had med cards, would be scared to come out because of social implications.
And the largest population base of consumers is in Sioux Falls, and fucking, and the mayor there, fucking, he's extremely anti-weed. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, de facto ban on cultivation there, so...
Even in Mitchell, they're still pretty...
Yeah, what the hell,
they're still rugged
dude?
On. If
what
you don't have your med card, your concentrate's still a controlled substance.
Oh, yeah, same as meth.
Yeah, it's a, you. If you have concentrate in a bag of dope, it's the same thing.
Concentrate, yeah, see, and that's why I think in the same container. That's why, like, same charge.
Yeah, see,
we're smart, right? Don't you feel smart charging somebody with like concentrated weed and meth for the same amount of time? Don't you feel really smart?
They did that to me
because you sound really.
They did
dumb.
That to me. I was pissed. I got pulled over one time and had something in the back, and I was just like, "Oh, you know," they're like, "Well, you got some weed." I'm like, "Yeah, that's cool. You can take it, whatever." And took my blunt, this and that, cool, whatever, and they. By my little puck I had, and I'm doing my thing, and they're like, "Oh, well, you're going to jail." And I'm like, "Why?"
Yeah.
I was like, "Why?" And they're like, "For this." I was like, "It's some weed. You're gonna put me in jail for some weed?
It's THC, bro.
Yep.
It's cool. It's cool."
But like, I don't think they do possession by ingestion anymore. They do for cocaine. They do for harder stuff and
meth. Yeah, meth.
For meth and cocaine and opiates, you can get possession by ingestion, but. Yep.
When they got a rack on charges.
Yeah, when they need help.
They literally can.
But for South Dakota being the way it is, like even Mitchell especially, the med has opened up a lot of space, a lot of breathing room with that.
Right.
Which is real nice. Because even now, you do something, you mention a medical card, they're like, because there's still the res card too. And that's another thing people have been questioning, because there's still the res card, and that's only legal on the res.
Yeah, the that's Native Nations, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't count those though. I mean, unless you're like,
see, I figure that's closer to the real
unless you're
number.
Native and you live like that's where you live, sure. But everybody else who got one, like,
man, well, that's the thing is you can leave.
Stop
there.
Fucking around. Dude.
You can do that, and you can get it. Like me and you could go get it. We could go there and we could buy our weed. But leaving. If we leave the res, we can still get pulled over and ticketed and charged.
How's that? Yeah. How I know my wife.
I have my res.
Yeah, she has her reg card, and like they fucking used to get those cards, and I fucking hate those cards. The botanical terp shit, man. Like fucking like when my fucking weed like. Cherry Sundae, man, and it fucking tastes like Cherry Sundae, dude. Like. Fucking Spartan kicked that motherfucker, dude.
They're adding
I couldn't
terps
smoke
to
that
everything,
fake shit, dude.
Just adding terps to everything.
Botanical
terpenes.
There was one time I know
they're
that,
not even like you know what I mean. It's botanical terpenes. It's not even weed derived. You know what I mean? Like
no, they're just throwing shit
it's
in.
It's just for flavor.
Yeah.
And that's the thing is, I was even told
spray pack.
They were doing a thing.
Yeah, gross. Didn't like
one
it.
Of my friends went there, and they even told her that they would use the same weed. Says they were selling something, and it was just getting. They would use the same weed, and then just put different. Botanical terpenes on it, but it would be the same weed, and then they charge a little bit extra.
And that shit tastes so strong, man! Like you don't even know.
I tried.
It's all you taste is that fucking fake synthetic.
I tried it a couple times,
and then it just ruins it.
Yeah, I don't like vape. You know, I don't. So like, it's not. I quit smoking. Never picked up the vape. Like my homie, fucking he fucking picked up the vape cart to quit smoking. I quit it all, so I don't fucking like. If I wanted to vape, I'd vape, right? Like I could go buy. I go down to the fucking. I go to Flames in South Dakota, man, or down in Verm, and I'd get all these fucking whatever the fuck they sell, man. If I wanted to vape,
dude. Yeah.
So to put that fake ass shit on weed. Is just stupid to me, and then people sit there and say, "Oh, well, it's popular here, and it's popular there." Man, fucking, I ain't never had anyone hit me up and say, "Hey, you got any of them
popular,
fucking fake shit?"
It's popular amongst uneducated people.
Yeah,
like people who just don't know that there's
fucking,
better shit out there.
It's a niche. It's a niche market in a fucking in a large market, right? Like that shit'll pass in L.A. because fucking people don't know it better. But
yeah.
You fucking the 10,000. You can't do that shit and.
You can't get away with it.
It's terrible.
You can't just spray terps on something and get rid of it anymore because there's too much beautiful shit out there that
people
see.
But they had the leg up.
And
they know that
there's a higher quality to be had.
Yep.
It's like, this will taste like strawberries, but fucking who gives a shit?
Well, we only got
weed. It's not supposed to.
We only got one jar of weed from them, and that was terrible.
They had the leg up by getting open as early as they did.
Yeah.
That's what did it.
That was a big win.
Yep. It was a bit of a push, but...
Props for making it a reality.
Anyone,
you know?
They got, for sure. For anyone who wanted it, fucking just fucking Nugget MD, man. It was crazy, dude. You fucking put your shit into it 15 minutes later, some motherfuckers calling you, dude.
I refused. I refused.
It was fake.
I wouldn't.
It was
I
like,
wouldn't do
like,
it. I waited
is
until.
Is this shit real?
I waited until my doctor at the fucking hospital prescribed
for real,
it.
Right.
And I was one of like 8 people. That she allowed to get weed because she was. I smoked weed my whole life. She knew that. I've always been honest with my family doctor. She knew that. And I've been in there sober before. I've gone in there completely sober, 100%. And I'm a fucking mess, dude. Like, I'm literally like a shaking fucking leaf. And so she's seen the difference between me smoking weed and she knows that I'm not smoking weed to because it's a fucking party or, you know, I mean, yeah, it's fun. Sure. But I'm smoking weed because without weed, I can't function. I cannot function in the regular world without marijuana.
Yeah. Then there's a lot of people like that, man. Yeah. We were just chilling with someone last night. Same way, man. Like, he smokes copious amounts of weed to deal with the bullshit of the world. You know what I mean? Like,
I used to be one of those conspiracy theory fucking dudes and all that. And I stopped watching the news because I was so fucking high anxiety all the fucking time, dude. Well, they're hitting you with panic all the fucking time. It's panic over this, panic over that, panic over. Man, show me a fucking do some Ron Burgundy shit. Show me a fucking squirrel riding fucking skis and shit behind a little tiny fake boat. Make fucking something, man. Why do I gotta go to bed every night scared? What the fuck good does that?
You know,
do?
I used to sell insurance and investments, and like it was funny because we had when there's fucking stock market fucking shit and like doom and gloom in the markets and shit, right? And whenever they're pumping that shit, like you could go back. We used to have this fold out paper of Time Magazine, right? And it like fucking every fucking, it's cyclical fucking, right? Like doom and gloom dates back the same fucking message all the way back to the fucking like the 1960s for Time Magazine, man. It's just like, it's nothing but doom and gloom all the way. Yeah. That's all they tell you. Like, you know what I mean? Fucking, you're never going to make it. You know what I mean? Fucking.
No, yeah, we're all about to die constantly all the time. Why? Stop that.
Right.
Like, anything could possibly
happen.
Your
money's not going to last forever. You're going to be broke when you're dying.
Yeah, but everybody's broke once they're dead.
Right, right.
You don't get shit.
Right.
I've been there fucking once. I gave a high five to the Grim Reaper one time. I'm like, that's crazy. Hey, what's up? Like, how you doing? And you know what? All the stuff that you're worried about, everything you give a shit about, all the stuff that keeps you up at night, all of it fucking goes away. Like, literally, right before fucking the lights start to go out, it's all fucking wonderful. It's like, fuck it, everybody's gonna be fine. And you just
hit that fucking...
You just get this feeling of euphoria, and you're like, everything's gonna be all right. No more of the stress, all that shit goes away.
Right.
All the worries, all the bullshit goes away.
Were we supposed to get hit by asteroids like 4 times already?
I mean, we probably, you know, some hit some places. I mean, over in Ukraine.
I'm pretty sure once a week I see something pop up.
Not Ukraine, but like Siberia and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was
Siberia had like 20 miles of fucking forest or some shit like that.
Just think about how much shit has to hit oceans.
Nobody lived there.
Like, and maybe not fucking sizable asteroids or some shit, but aren't those called meteorites?
Yeah,
meteorites. Some of that shit has to hit the fucking, like, there's so much surface area in the ocean, Antarctica, poles, like, you know what I mean? The populated planet is fucking significantly smaller.
But then you take it back to, like, 12,000 years ago when most shit was frozen and people lived on a coast that doesn't exist anymore.
Right.
We don't explore that shit at all.
Dude, fucking...
You go out miles from the coast, pretty much anywhere you can find little signs of fucking past shit, but nobody wants to fucking talk about it,
right?
Because it doesn't agree with what they say.
I've been digging into some of that shit. Most of it came on the Joe Rogan podcast and shit, dude. the younger Dryas theory.
Graham Hancock,
dude.
Big fan of Graham Hancock.
Dude, shit, you get like
that podcast will get you hooked.
I bought one of his books before he was on one of the books before he was on Rogan.
Yeah,
I bought one of his books.
Yeah, that shit's nuts, man.
Yeah,
like, you know, it's there if you look. Type shit, right?
That's just it.
And they don't want to look.
The only reason I'm so intrigued with it is because that's a belief that I've had since I was like a fucking freshman in high school. I always believed, because they found remains of like 200,000 years old remains of people. And I'm like, well, fuck you. There's no fucking way we've been picking berries and throwing fucking stones for fucking 200,000 years. And then one day we're just like, man, wouldn't it be a lot easier if we all just lived in big groups?
Right.
Fuck you, dude.
They are.
And it all lines up with like 11,600 years ago, there was a big something happened, and you get the story of Atlantis. Every tribe around the world, every group has a story of the great flood, and it was a great flood for everybody because everybody lived on the fucking coast.
Right.
So it seemed like the world was destroyed because all the coastal things were destroyed.
Right.
It's fucking
They actually found bones. They were like 8 to 10 foot tall bones. Buddy was telling me about this.
Giants and shit. Yeah,
the Giants in Nevada. It was out in Lovelock. They found it was like 8 to 10 foot fucking bones. Then they covered it up. Smithsonian covered it up with something.
Right.
Like show you an 8 foot bone.
Boom. How you like me now? All right, we should take a break, dude. We gotta fucking go smoke again. We gotta go smoke again. I haven't smoked in like, I feel like it's been at least a half hour, and I can't take that.
Sesh it up.
Yeah, we gotta go smoke. We'll be right back.